time you gotta watch. Alright. Alright, so I'm gonna open this up because I have quite the diverse array here of Superman talent. 75 years. I won't live that long. And Superman will go on, I can't even imagine, 750 years until we run out of paper. Until the sun burns out, exactly. What does that mean to you people? I mean, you are obviously representatives of it, but what does it mean to you emotionally, from a personal sense? Anybody can jump in. Start at the end.
Just for me, I mean, it's about...
And when you even considered taking the role, did the responsibility of the role dawn on you at that point? What was that like? Jack, Molly, Dylan...
Okay, I'll take it. Yes, the responsibility... I was fully aware of the responsibility. But when it came to it affecting me, I tried to push it back in my mind because it's so important to everyone, or certainly to a lot of people. And if I were to allow that kind of pressure and that responsibility to affect me, I don't think I would have done the role justice. And so I just tried to focus myself on the task at hand, which is representing the character properly, as opposed to fulfilling the hopes and dreams of so many people out there, which is a pretty daunting task, and even now I still put that in the back of my mind.
You got the call from Sex Night, we're playing a role-playing game.
Yes.
Have you gotten back on it, and what level are you in?
Actually, I have not gotten back into it. I've had no time, and as I think anyone who knows that game in particular knows that it becomes a bit of an addiction, and I need to sleep, so I need work.
Was it Minecraft?
No.
Firefighters and
firefighters.
I just generally wanted to thank you guys all for the contributions you've given over the years to Superman to get to the point where it is now and to give us a movie here. And see, that's just so on point for what we've always wanted to see in a Superman film. And then I had to push Henry more or less about your diet and your training. I recently did like a 2 or 3 week no carbs, just to kind of get in shape. It sucks. I understand what you went through. What did you hate the most about that? I know you're contractually obligated to do that. And what did you enjoy the most about just stuffing your face with carbs at the end?
The thing the dieting bit. I was in such good hands with Mark Twight, Mike Blevins. Thank you. When it came to the leaning stuff, they had me primed and everything, and yes, they cut out a lot of carbs from my diet and to prep me for the shirtless scenes. The most difficult thing was just that it was over a 6 week period that we were staying lean. And so instead of it being just for one day, you know, like bodybuilders do, and you stand under a nice light and you get a spray tan, I had to maintain that and still work long hours and still get up in the morning and train. And that was probably my least favorite thing. But at the end of that, I did get the chance. Zach and Debbie Snyder bought me an apple pie from a local pie company. I had a tub of ice cream, and then I ordered a big 16-inch pizza on top of that. And they were going.
What was your favorite part of the physical aspect of becoming Superman?
How do I say this? You know what? Getting in that kind of shape was incredibly hard work, and it was, you know, a gruel and a slog every day to get up at 3 a.m. and train before work, and you would ultimately end up being a 15-hour day. It was exhausting, but I got to be in that kind of shape. I had an amazing trainer in Mark Twight, and when you are feeling that strong, it's a good feeling, I'm not gonna lie. you feel very fit and healthy, and so just that feeling of health and fitness, and yeah, that was probably the best part of it, just feeling healthy. Thank you.
congrats to present the actor number one comic.
It's not me.
Not Henry Cavill. All right. This is more Henry, actually. What did you take away from past Superman roles and incorporate into Man of Steel?
Well, when it came to me creating this character for me personally, and with the groundwork and framework that my friend David here had laid down, I wanted to avoid watching previous live-action stuff, purely because that was, in my opinion, someone else's interpretation of the character in the comic books. And I want this to be our interpretation of the character without anyone else's influence affecting that, and therefore muddying the line between source material and live action. So I didn't use any influence from previous performances.
If you are not staying for the